Hey guys, hello and welcome to Zen Innovations and welcome to this fresh new video. Guys, I'm really happy that my channel was able to inspire a lot of you to use solar energy or green energy. And on my channel, I get a comment related to this phenomenon that, sir, I'd like to use solar energy or green energy for running my refrigerator. Is it possible and is it even beneficial to run your fridge using solar inverter? So in this video, we are going to talk on this topic and I'm going to give you three golden tips regarding this discussion. Plus, I'll give you a fourth bonus point. So I suggest that you watch this video entirely without skipping. So you guys hit that neat little like button down below and let's begin this video. Guys, so the first point is related to the type of fridge which we have. And the latest technology in fridge is based on inverter technology. And the older kind of fridge which used to have those big huge compressors used to have a lot of startup draw or inrush current. And that inrush current feels like a punch in face for your solar inverter or solar PCU. So over here, I'd like to clarify that if you guys are interested in running your refrigerator on any kind of inverter or PCU, then absolutely make sure that the fridge which you are trying to run is based on inverter technology. I do not suggest that you run your regular older kind of fridges on your inverter or solar PCU. And guys, over here, let me show you. So I have this LG refrigerator. It is a pretty huge fridge. So 516 liters. And this fridge has been running effortlessly on my UTL Gamma Plus, which is just 1 kVA solar PCU. And here you can see how the fridge looks. So guys, so the first point is that if you want to run the fridge on your solar PCU, then make sure that it is the inverter based model. Let's come to the second point. And second point is related to the size of your fridge. Now a lot of guys over here ask me that whether a small fridge makes any kind of difference. And let me share my experience over here is that the size of fridge actually does not change much regarding the jerk load or the startup load of your fridge. And I have seen that many times the smaller fridges draw the same kind of power which your large fridge does. The only difference is that the compressor cuts out faster because they have a smaller area to cool. But the inrush current of these small fridges is just as big as their big brothers. So no, the size of your fridge does not change anything. Just make sure that your fridge is based on inverter technology. Be it big or small, you can run it on your solar PCU. And let's come to the third point. And third point is very interesting. And I got this comment on my channel which said that, well, here we understood that if we want to run the fridge on solar inverter, then it has to be based on inverter. So that is crystal clear. Alright. So the second part in this phenomenon is that can we convert our existing fridge? So if I have an old kind of fridge which is working all right, but it is not based on inverter technology. It uses those big large compressors and has a lot of jerk load. So is there any method where we can convert that kind of old fridge into an inverter based fridge? So over here, let me tell you that sadly, none of the manufacturers seem to offer any kind of kit or PCB that will allow you to convert your existing old technology fridge into an inverter based fridge. And if you are looking to do this as a DIY, then let me tell you that financially it does not make any sense because the major components which will need a complete replacement would be your PCB or the motherboard. And along with that, you will need a new compressor. And inverter based fridges have a different kind of compressor compared to the normal ones. And all this is going to be pretty expensive business. And let's factor in all the wiring cost as well as the installation cost. And at this point, your cost of converting this old fridge into an inverter based fridge might as well exceed the cost of a new 3-star or 5-star rated fridge. And guys, if you are looking to buy or exchange any of your old fridges into an inverter based new branded fridge, then make sure to check this particular video over here. And this video contains a buying guide as well as some of my top picks where I have shown that what kind of fridge you should buy. So the video will be waiting for you over here, or you can find the link in a description below. Make sure to go ahead and check it out. Along with that, I'll also provide some of my favorite fridges which you can buy using the buying links in description below. Alright, so three points have been cleared over here. And before we move on to the fourth bonus point, let me give you a little tour regarding my fridge setup. So this fridge is from LG and it is a huge 500 liter fridge which I am using on my solar inverter. And the power consumption of this fridge is pretty minimal. I'll say it hovers somewhere between 50 to 70 watts. And so I think somewhere once or twice a day, the power consumption goes up to 250 or 260 watts. And that happens due to the defrost cycle. So when a few minutes of those defrost cycle comes in, the power consumption goes up, but usually it stays somewhere in this 50 to 60 watt range. And I have also noticed that sometimes the consumption comes way down. So it also comes down to just 9 or 10 watts at times. So here is how my fridge works using solar energy. And while showing you this fridge, let's move on to the fourth point, which is the bonus point. And the bonus point is regarding the wiring of your fridge. Now over here we can see that I have installed a separate board and I have plugged in my fridge into this board. But over here behind the fridge, as we can see, that this is the original main socket and I have just kept it alive without disturbing. So what I recommend over here is that while you are making a new board or a new wiring for utilization of your inverter connection or your solar energy for the fridge, make sure to leave this main socket alive. And if possible, have both of those sockets side by side, so you can have one inverter socket and you can have one mains socket. And this thing is going to be very useful when the time goes bad. So let's say that if you have a few very cloudy days in a row, or say if your battery comes down, or say if your solar inverter becomes faulty, then this mains socket is going to save your day. So during these times of crisis, what you can do is you can simply unplug your fridge from the inverter socket and put it into the main socket, and there it will start working. So let's summarize this video. And in this summary, I'll tell you two highlight points. So the first thing is that absolutely, if you want to run your fridge on inverter, make sure that it has an inverter based compressor. And the second point is regarding money. So is it beneficial to run your fridge using solar energy? And the answer is a resounding yes. It's absolutely beneficial. So if you have a 3-star or 5-star rated fridge, then you should absolutely try to run on your solar energy. Get the wiring done using a professional wireman. Get a board installed nicely. And please try to run it using solar energy. And let me know in comments below how was your experience when trying to run a nice fridge using your solar inverter. So what happens is that the fridge is a continuous load. You can say that it's a 24-hour load. And we never turn off our fridges. So what happens is that when this kind of load is shifted to solar energy, then the bill saving will be pretty neat, and all of this 24 hours of power consumption will go to your solar inverter rather than going through your meter or rather than going through your pockets, that means your grid. So if at all possible, try to convert your fridges by using solar energy. Make sure to follow all those four points which we discussed before. So that was it for this neat little video, guys. I hope you liked it. Share this video around with your friends so that even they can be clear regarding these doubts. And these kind of Q&A videos and these kind of interesting tips keep coming on my channel. So if you're interested in watching these videos, make sure to hit that nice little subscribe button down below, because subscribing is absolutely free. So that's it for this video, guys. Take care and have a nice day.